It is no wonder we are a nation of drunkards. We, the citizens of this great nation, are just overwhelmed by what's going on in our country. And I think a little shocked as reports of just how far gone we are surface again and again. And it seems to be a worldwide phenomenon. It's every man for himself out here. And the lack of accountability in our leadership seems to be trickling down to civil society, and people are just doing what pleases them without much concern for the repercussions of their actions. Our financially challenged government is borrowing money left, right, and center. And while we, the citizens, have been made to understand that times are tough, we see money being availed to increase salaries at the national broadcaster, a whole lot of millions, 50 odd to host the SADC conference, and another 15 million for the land conference, and the president just jet-setting around the world. I mean, don't they have access to the best technology? They could most easily Skype and discuss whatever it is they need to without it being a burden to the taxpayer. The just-ended land conference took place despite vehement opposition from civil society and other organizations due to the unfair representation of affected parties. I spoke to the Landless People's Movement's Henny Seibeb about this.
Number one, we know that we were only invited at the last minute. The president had a whole year, not only a whole year, since last year when he made an announcement that he will postpone this particular conference because of the concerns that were then raised by NANCOF and LPM. So we were hoping that the process would be inclusive, leading towards the conference, but that was not to be. And as much as we add our grievances, the traditional leaders comprising of the Obahero traditional authorities, the Damara King's Council, and the Nama Traditional Leaders Association also had their press conference on Friday. They add, amongst others, that the invitation is too small, they can't go with two or three delegations, and that they were not duly consulted on the points that were going to be discussed. And also, the key point, the ancestral land claims, really should be the key matter on the program. So the government tried to push it away, and they were not ready to discuss on that particular matter in detail. And of course, the statements that were offered by the Swapo Party Elders Council also added to the process. And NANCOF also had the similar reason. So all of them met, and some of the political parties joined, and then they dismissed the conference that is undertaking as a sham conference, as a fake conference.